Welcome back to Salon Talk. We are at Petra Salon. My chica, Miss Photogenics, getting her nails done. These ladies have been in the salon enjoying some special services where you can come and get yourself checked out and put together, and they will take good care of you. So make sure you post up at Bugolobi with us. That's where we are today. And we're talking Miss Curvy. We have all the ladies from the Miss Curvy pageant, Miss Curvy, the first and second runner up, Miss Photogenic as well. And we also have the baddest comedian, Dolly Wondo, in the salon as well. Why are we laughing?
Huh? I don't know why they are laughing.
Why are you laughing? It's actually let's say something
to,
funny.
It's supposed to be me to laughing.
Maybe your comedy starts with the name.
Maybe.
Huh? Don't even have to say anything. Starts with the name.
Yeah, okay.
So right before we went for a break, we had Mariam telling us how she transitioned from being, you know, a smaller size to plus size, right? And I want to hear what Maria Praise's experience was, because she did talk about growing up plus size. What was your experience? Were you bullied? Were you treated different?
Me, I grew up plus size. Up to now, I'm still plus size. Mm. I didn't have any transition of size. What? Mm. No, mine is a different case. Mm. I grew up plus size, but the only disadvantage I faced was I looked mature. I looked as if I was the mother in class, and people would call me mother, yet I didn't have any child. Mm. I was given hard tasks of work to do in class because of my size, because I looked mature. Mm. And when I tell you my age right now, you'll say, no, I don't, that's not your age, because of
you
the body.
You can tell us. It's fine. In fact, let's all tell our ages.
I live in the future, actually.
I think now we know why Dolly Wondo is here. And you're 21?
Yeah, I'm just 21. But when you look at me, I look like someone who is 25, 24.
Even and 25 is less.
25 is less.
You look 30.
30. Mm. So it really tortured me psychologically that even at one time, I refused going to school because of my size, because I really couldn't fit in my fellow peers. It really gave me hard time to fit in them. And whenever they would be conversing, I would feel out of place.
Isn't it a shame how something that a lot of people got teased for, especially in a country like Africa, where most of our mothers are plus size or most of our sisters are plus size, how something like curves is now a beauty trend? People are buying curves and bums.
I think her getting to a point of wanting to quit school was over, maybe because she's a girl or something. Because I remember we had a plus size guy at school. We used to call him Giant. Giant would bully us instead.
But that was respect.
No.
When you're a big guy in school, only you're a boss man.
This guy would literally tease us. Let's say he would pick like five guys and gives you a schedule when you're going to clean his shoes. He says, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday.
If you don't do it, he sits on you. What was the repercussion?
What would he do?
Of course, we just feared him. So no one ever dared to.
Now you see, that's taking advantage of your power.
I think
but then, a girl and boys usually take it to be that because of their size, they take it to be superior.
You tend
to be superior.
So,
but when I'm a girl, I have this fear in me.
Giant, wherever you are, still.
You know, and it's very sad, because now it's the trend. Women are getting butt injections, putting weird things in their bodies. You go to someone's closet where they used to keep underwear, now they have underwear and bums. So
I think it is
removal of ribs just to make your waist smaller. Then you have to walk around with what do they call, waist strain. Life is hard. Because we are trying to aspire to the people that we used to make fun of. And it's very, you wanted to say something.
I wanted to say that also men contribute
to,
they
what?
Actually contribute a lot.
We contribute to?
Yes.
To search.
Men
contribute to the teasing. To the teasing. Now, for example, for my case, my ex-husband, he really trashed me emotionally. It was not necessary. You know, it's okay for you guys to say, I'm sorry, I've changed my mind. Yeah. It's okay. You leave me nursing my heart. You get. But this business of piling all that emotional stuff, you know, putting someone down emotionally, using words like you look like an animal, you're not appealing, boy, that's not fair. Because you see, you wonder, the mouth which used to tell you, I love you, you look beautiful, you look amazing, it is the same.
But also, if we get to that point, there comes, you know, one of the problem we face in a relationship is we tend to think everything is going to be constant right from the beginning.
Yeah.
You get me? Then also, at times it gets to a point where for instance, you're seeing your woman getting out of shape, like the real shape you admired her about.
Mm.
So you try to tell her to do something. And she totally ignores you.
Mm.
You I don't know if you get me.
Something saying.
Like you need to attend gym classes, uh-huh. and then she's lazy. Now trust me, if I loved you in a shape 8, and then you go in shape 9, trust me, my mind is going to change.
Let me ask you a question.
Yes.
That also raises another problem. But then let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
Do you think it is in your right to determine what a woman looks like or not?
I guess the fact that I made a move to you and fell in love with you for what you are, and then you change to something else, don't expect my mind to be still thinking of the same thing.
Mm.
It's going to change.
The same way,
I'll go and buy, let's say, proper jeans, and the other day we are having a new design on the market. And then I end up buying the other one and trash this out.
So sometimes
when you change, you don't change for the good.
Let me ask a question.
Yes.
So it's okay when, if say I'm dating Donny Von Doe, number one comedian, he drives the latest Benz, and you know, the money is right, buys me all the latest iPhones, and then one day, Donny Von Doe, the gigs are not coming anymore. The Benz had to switch to the first Benz he used to drive back in the day, which is not even legal in Kampala anymore. I still have an iPhone of 2006. It's okay for me to also say, you know what?
Let me explain something to you. As far as I know, every woman, based on what they would love to achieve in life, is the kind of man they go for.
Every woman is the kind of man they go
no,
for.
No, I mean, if her dream, let's say, is to drive, let's say, a Mercedes Benz AMG C200 or something. Okay.
Yeah,
let's say. let's say her dream is to drive a Benz of, let's say, model 2012. She won't fall for a man who is dreaming of driving a Premier. You get me?
Yeah.
In most cases, her dreams should be in the same direction as your dreams.
Okay.
That's if you don't have what you wants to be at the moment.
Okay.
You get me?
Yes.
Not a man who is going to come and say, a woman would love to see a man who is focused for the future. And that future is bright.
Okay.
But if you come to me and I tell you,
you're missing the question. The question is, in the same light that you say, oh, I was dating Maritza.
At the end of the day, if I am doing a backslide in my financials and everything, and I'm not showing any interest of fighting to get back to where I was or even more, you're going to go away.
So I have every right to go. I can go, eh?
No, I'm not saying you have a right. But most women will go.
Then even though you said if you are this size 8 and you become 9, me, I have to go. So
if you become Scarlett, also me, I can go.
So
I'm not saying you should go, but in most cases they are going to go.
Now, that's the thing. What happens? And you know,
to love that size, you're supposed to love the person. Why should I?
Can I tell you something? I love gadgets. I love cars.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. However, the specs matter. You get me?
I love cars.
I love cars. Actually, if it was not for that, then I should have been holding the first iPhone I had in 2009.
Mm.
But every time a spec up, every time there is an upgrade in a device, I'll go for it.
Yeah.
You get me?
The question to you, Jolly Wondo, and also the ladies here today is, when you find yourself a partner, right? Yeah. Why is it that we still, as much as we're like, oh, I'm all about love, he sends me messages, he calls me, at the core of our society, we will still be, oh, she has to look like this. Oh my God, she's putting on weight, chiwede. Oh, he has to have this. Oh my God, he's losing his money, chiwede. Why is it that even as we aspire to get married and have long-lasting relationships, we are still hell-bent on the things that are constantly going to change, for starters, which you brought up at the start of the conversation, constantly going to change, and also we have no control over?
I guess.
Answer.
I Why guess are for we the like weight, that? I guess for the weight, it has control.
Does it?
Yeah, it does.
You forget that women have birth control methods that change, that actually increase your estrogen and change your weight. You have no control over that.
I know about that.
Also, there's some women who get tired of being skinny. Huh? And they decide, even me, I want to look like Miss Curvy. Why not? Huh? Why does that become a problem for you?
Because that's not the person I admired in you in the first place.
So initially you were here for the body, not my personality.
That's what I told you. When I go for a gadget, I go for the specs as well.
Stop talking. Gadget. Wama, Turiwano. Gadget and mine are two different things.
Okay, when I come for you, it is about your, according to me.
My specifics.
Exactly. It's about your height, your weight, your looks and everything.
No now, offense, if but that is a shallow platform if on which to pick up.
If you got an accident and got a scar, it's okay, I can stay around. I'll stay around. It's understandable.
What if I broke a leg and I had to cut it off?
Would you leave? Stay around.
But for the weight,
you
wouldn't.
But you know, even the weight, they can cut it off. So why don't you just stay?
Then why don't you cut it off?
Please, go away.
Cut off the weight.
Oh, all right, you know what?
I love that 80 kg woman, and you're going for
don't even. You guys, I have the perfect way to close to before we go for a break.
What I do physically, I can carry a jerry.
You don't even know this.
When it is full, and you, a slender girl, carries it. She will see like it's very heavy. But for
okay,
me,
okay. To me, it's not about flexibility. We need,
guys,
it's about the weight.
Because we need,
the
guys, weight,
this is genetic.
Guys, we need to go. We need to go for a break. But before we go for a break, I want you guys to think about this question, especially because for Dolly Wondo's sake, all right? When we raise our kids to focus on things like weight, to focus on material, on things that are constantly changing, where are we headed in the world? And that, how does it affect us? Now, she's giving you all points and answers. So when we get back, more points and answers. Just think about it. When we focus on things like that, where does it lead us to? We'll be right back. You're watching Salon Talk.